White and Brown. Tatum out there with Porzingis, and it's Holiday in at the one spot. You know, Brent, these two teams are both known for getting their three-point shot away and connecting. So will it be three-point bombs all night long for us?
Oh, yeah. Put on a seatbelt, strap into the cockpit. We're fighting a war exclusively from the three-point line tonight. But for these teams, that's the go-to. So I think it all depends on who can get hot and stay hot.
Now, here's Gilgeous Alexander. Giddy kicks to Dort. White against Giddy. Holmgren sets the screen for Giddy. Shot clock at three. And there's Holmgren. That's good. On the assist from Giddy. Holmgren's got the opening basket of the game for the Thunder. Now Tatum. He averages over 27 points a game and seems to always find a way to score. White against Giddy. Outside Williams. Back to Giddy. Williams, a screen on White. Pass to Williams. Oh, he blocked it and deflects off the backboard. Holiday, the pass to Tatum. Passes it to White. Outside Holiday. Porzingis sets the pick for Holiday. Drains it from beyond the arc.
Fairly efficient from the three-point line. Holiday can punish you from the arc.
Ask any player who's the best perimeter defender, they'll all say Drew Holiday.
Drew is elite on that end of the floor. He can force turnovers, disrupt and just damage plays and challenge all the shots. You think you've lost him, and he's right there with you.
Now Tatum, after the missed three from Chet Holmgren. Porzingis with a screen on Gilgeous Alexander. Tatum no good.
And that was almost a block. Still did enough to alter the shot.
Yeah, altering the shot, just as long as there's a miss, that kind of energy not wasted.
Williams gets the bucket.
Yeah, not a perfectly set screen there, but got him just enough room to get that shot off.
Outside Tatum. On the wing, Holiday. Back to Tatum. A three-pointer off the mark. The Thunder with the lead. Holmgren up top. Some nice passing by Oklahoma City here. Here's Gilgeous Alexander. Rebounded by the Celtics. Their last meeting was in Oklahoma City, where they were unable to fight off the Thunder.
Well, they were on the wrong side of a very close matchup last time they met, but what a great game.
Now, here's Brown. Right now, checking his stats, he's averaging over 23 points a game. Porzingis kicks to Brown. Traps in the tray.
And it's been great to see Brown's offense continue to evolve. Nice work there off the catch.
Giddy against White. Pass to Gilgeous Alexander. And they wasted no time getting those 3 points back.
Both teams running perimeter-oriented plays that are working.
Well, both of them looking towards the three-point line. And I like to see that, especially when the results are made buckets.
Porzingis can't hit. The Thunder have gone 50% from the field, hitting 3 of 6 since the opening tip. And you look at the Thunder style of play, very fast-paced.
And because of that, they put up a lot of shots. And their goal really is to overwhelm you and wear you down. Of course, they allow plenty of shot attempts as well.
Last game for Boston, they picked up the W against Charlotte. Holiday finds Tatum. Back to Holiday. And Brown now atop the key. Porzingis sets the pick for White. And the Celtics hit again from deep. Several lead changes going on here in the early portion of this game.
It reminds me of that Cameo song, Back and Forth.
Now, here's Gilgeous Alexander. He had 19 points in the win against the Knicks in New York. And so it looks like the Celtics will retain possession here. And a new group in here for the Thunder. And so Horford will bring it up for Boston. Brown with it. A three ball. Unable to get that one. One quarter in the books, and it's been a close one so far. Celtics lead by two. And the second quarter will get underway just after this short break. And close game underway so far. We'll see if either of these teams can jump out in the second quarter. What do you guys think about the Celtics here in this one?
Coming in hot. They were sharp from the perimeter right out of the gate.
They just couldn't seem to know what it was that they needed to do and how to stick them from outside. The defense pretty lost.
The Celtics with the lead. On the floor for Oklahoma City, getting going here in the second quarter. We've got Hayward. Williams is out there with Wiggins. Then there's Shai Gilgeous-Alexander. And it's Wallace in at the two spot. No doubt, Craig, Jason Tatum is an all-NBA player. And this guy continues to improve.
And JT's scoring average increasing in each of his first five seasons. I just love how he gets to the line more, being more aggressive. Tatum was the guy on a finals team at just 24 years old.
Boston's gone 3-6 tonight when they've let it fly from downtown. Tatum passes to Mykhailiuk. Horford with a screen on Wallace. Down low. Here's Tillman. The shot's good on the assist by Horford. Tillman's got the lead up to two now for the Celtics. To the inside, Gilgeous-Alexander.
How about the vertical of Gilgeous-Alexander, a guard who can get up and throw it down.
And we play just over a minute of basketball here in the second quarter. And here is Tatum. He's coming off a 25-point game against the Hornets in Charlotte.
And he also positioned himself perfectly to grab all those rebounds, guys. Can't forget about the fundamentals.
Outside, Gilgeous-Alexander. Wiggins outside. Back to Gilgeous-Alexander. Down to five on the shot clock. And the layup's good off the glass. Gilgeous-Alexander's got 7 points.
Well, they're trying to take command of this game, but it's been competitive so far.
Yeah, everybody's trying to get away from one another, and the threads are keeping them close. This has been highly competitive.
Here's Tatum after the made shot from Shai Gilgeous-Alexander. Up against it inside, Tatum fights through, hatchets his way to the rack. Quarter number two, we're about 2 minutes in. Here's Gilgeous-Alexander, 7 points in the game. Drives to the hoop. It's rebounded by Mykhailiuk.
I'm not going to see that very often. The defense in the vicinity, but still, he's not one to blow layups.
And, Greg, the way the Celtics have approached this season in terms of intensity, I think they clearly feel, though, they have unfinished business.
They've been so close to a title for a number of years. They've even been title favorites at times. It's part of the maturation process, as excruciating as it may be.
Now, Hayward. After Jason Tatum missed on that last three-pointer. The pass to Williams. Takes the three. His shot is good, making him a perfect 2 for 2 from the floor.
Yeah, and they're starting to warm up from the field this quarter.
Celtics trail by 3. Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, a cold stretch offensively for sure.
Here's Tatum. Solid shot by Tatum with the defender right there.
And how about the mindset of Tatum? Even when the D is in his grill, he somehow finds a way to get shots up and over them.
And first timeout of the game called for Oklahoma City. And a new group in here for the Thunder. Chet Holmgren, he's checked in for Williams. Williams comes in for Wiggins. Dort, he's checked in for Gordon Hayward. And Josh Giddey's subbed in for Gilgeous Alexander. .143 left to play here in the half. Holmgren the pass to Dort. And Greg, we still see players embellishing contact. Is enough being done to discourage those creative flourishes?
We're talking about flopping, right? I mean, we're seeing the league experiment assessing a technical free throw. It's necessary, or guys will keep jerking their heads and falling down, and who wants to see that?
6 to shoot. Porzingis kicks to Brown. 3-pointer, Horford, and the 3-ball is good. Horford's got the lead up to 2 now for the Celtics.
The defense certainly makes its presence felt, but Horford's so talented, he calmly rises up and buries the jumper over them. That's easy.
And Williams gets it to go on the assist by Wallace.
And those are the kind of nice inside looks they've gotten here in the first half.
50 seconds left to play here in the second quarter. Brown against Dort. 13 feet away. And it's Brown missing.
And the rebound battle split evenly thus far.
Wallace against Holiday. Now here's Wallace. Tight defense on him. Pass to Holmgren. And the Thunder another 3.
And the lead should be safe if they can keep shooting the basketball like this.
20 seconds left in the first half. Brown feeling it out a bit. Horford with a screen on Dort. Here's Brown. And the last second attempt does not go in for him.
Lou Dort, one of the better defensive players in the NBA.
And that's it for the first half of action. What's been a very close game here. It's the Thunder. They lead by 3. And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thanks very much. Jason, still a close one. What do you think happened there in the first half?
Feeling all right. We got to do a much better job defensively. we're not where we need to be, especially on defensive end, so we got to pick it up second half.
Yeah, we'll see if you're more connected in the second half. Thanks. Back to you guys.
Thanks, David. And we'll be back shortly following halftime to get the third quarter underway.
And we welcome you to halftime as the Boston Celtics are getting everything they can handle so far.
Their offense is too predictable right now. Get nothing on the interior. They look like Kenny when he's running. Unbalanced.
I've got enough balance to outrun you. Let's go. Anytime.
And since we've got a moment, let's go to social media. See what's on the fans' minds. Another question for us, this one from Airtime Derek, who asks, Shaq, you had a number of memorable posterizers during your career. Which one is your favorite?
I'll show it to you right now. This Chris Dudley dunk. Check it out.
Ooh, I remember that. Don't push him like that, Shaq.
Well, he needed to get off me.
Oh, my goodness.
Gotta say, impressive. And that'll do it for halftime. We send you back to Kevin Harlan, who has the second half call.
And as we get into this third quarter, as we've seen so far, neither team able to create much separation on the scoreboard yet. So it's Boston now. It's a three-point game. The wing pairing, it's White and Brown. Tatum out there with Porzingis, and it's Holiday in at the point. And that's the group for Joe Mazzulla as we begin the second half. And it's White missing.
Well, he's a guy they count on to produce from the mid-range. He doesn't miss too many open looks from there.
Giddy the pass to Williams. Williams a screen on White. Giddy against Holiday. Just five on the clock. Oklahoma City needs to get off a shot. Williams for three. And Boston with the rebound. It feels like Porzingis, Brent, has been in the NBA forever, doesn't it? But he is still only in his 20s.
Yeah, it's kind of a head-scratcher. He's been traded a few times, missed a year due to ACL injury, but the unicorn has persevered, and he's worked on his body, still adding some to his game, and you wonder if he's finally found a home.
And with a little over a minute gone, the second half is underway. Pass to Giddy. Holmgren sets the screen for Giddey. Outside for Gilgeous-Alexander. Lets it go with a three. And Tatum pulls it down. And here's Tatum. He'll bring it up for the Boston Celtics. They haven't given up any points here in the second half. Over Williams, and it's Boston with another.
Oh, the control Tatum plays with is just mesmerizing.
Oklahoma City's gotten a success rate of just over 50% from three-point tonight. 4 of 7 shooting. A moment now to hear from our sideline reporter, Hall of Famer David Aldridge. David.
Thank you very much, Kevin. Oklahoma City is a franchise that has to have patience. Coach Mark Daigneault said, there's no schedule. That's the biggest thing. There's a way of operating that we're very confident in and that we're going to bet on. And that's developing, having a good environment, and trying to play a style that scales forward. We're just going to keep our head down. Kevin, back to you.
And keep going straight ahead. All right, DA, thanks. Now, here's Gilgeous-Alexander following the miss by Porzingis. Gilgeous-Alexander passes to Dort. Shot clock at 6. Over in the corner, Williams. Over Brown. Hands the shot from the wing. 6 points for Williams. And not even 3 quarters out of the way. So many lead changes.
The fans, guys, are getting their money's worth. Heck, I should have paid to watch this one. It's been a nail bite.
Now, here's Brown. Pass to Porzingis. Back to Brown. Porzingis sets the pick for Brown. Hits despite the tough D. Brown's got 5.
And some question Brown's jumper coming into the league. Now no one is because of shots like that.
And the pass to Holmgren. Williams kicks to Giddey. Oklahoma City moving it around. Pass to Gilgeous-Alexander. Off target from three-point range.
And even without that three ball dropping for him, the defense should have done more on that last play.
Got that bucket in no time at all. Now it's a 4-point Celtic lead.
And that passing ability really helps separate Tatum from so many others because the defense has to focus on his ability to score.
Now here's Holmgren. He's got 5. It's hauled in by Brown. Inside. Inside Tatum.
And it just seems that every pass they make is leading to a score. Just great ball movement.
Thunder trailing by 6. Now here's Giddey. He has yet to score. Gilgeous-Alexander kicks to Giddey. To Gilgeous-Alexander. Three on the clock. Fade away. And Boston with the rebound.
Not a way to get out of a funk. He needs to be looking for good, solid, more efficient shots. Not the wild one he took there.
Porzingis high post. And the dunk by Porzingis.
And the advantage they have starting to increase. Things are coming together for them at a really opportune time.
Coaches always talk about the first 5 minutes of the third quarter. They have definitely increased their energy level here.
23 seconds left here in the third quarter. Holiday against Gilgeous-Alexander. Holmgren with a screen on Holiday to stop the run, and the dunk by Holmgren.
I mean, sneaky. When he moves around the floor, Holmgren takes you out of the play, slips past, and just rolls to the hoop.
And so it's Boston with a 6-point lead at the end of the quarter. Their shooting has been the big key. Their percentage from the field so far has been terrific. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. And let's take now this moment to bring up our State Farm assist of the game.
Yeah, an easy choice tonight. Look at the precision on this pass. Put it on a platter for him.
Well, there's a way to break down the defense with the handle, but you can do it with the pass. Prime example of that right there.
And it's been a very competitive game so far as we get rolling here in quarter number four. And Oklahoma City, looking who they've got to start the fourth quarter. Wallace is out there with Gilgeous Alexander. Then it's Wiggins, then it's Hayward, and it's Williams at the pivot spot manning the middle. Wallace with a screen for Hayward. Williams for three. Rebounded by the Celtics. Tatum's got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. The three. The three from Tatum.
The defense is far too slow to close out on those three-point attempts.
Hayward outside. On the wing, Wallace. From the arc. The basket good off the assist from Hayward. Hayward's got three assists tonight.
And I like the back and forth here, showing confidence from range.
It seems like they're going to find out who can make the deepest threes. Right now, it's a shootout.
Tatum, that's for two. Here's Tillman, and the layup is good. And the Celtics lead by eight.
And a nice spark for their offense here in the second half. Now above 50% for the game.
Wiggins outside. Back to Gilgeous Alexander. Looking to get back on track here, and it's good on the way in.
Impressive make by SGA, not fazed by that defender.
Just over a minute and a half played here in the fourth. Outside, Tatum passes it to Pritchard. Picked by Horford. And that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle and two shots coming up. That one on Gilgeous Alexander.
And you know what? You allow a guy to get right to the rim like that, that's your only option.
He's off on the first. And a new group in here for the Thunder. Holmgren, he's checked in for Williams. Williams comes in for Wiggins. Dort, he's checked in for Gordon Hayward. And Josh Giddey's subbed in for Wallace. And he sinks the second. In the 2016 and 17 drafts, GA, Boston ended up with the third pick overall both of those years.
And they nailed those picks, getting Jaylen Brown and Jason Tatum back-to-back, setting up their franchise for years.
White the pass to Pritchard. Brown outside. Good on the three-point shot. And the Celtics lead by eight.
A guy who shoots the three well. And without hesitation, defense can't afford to give Brown that much room.
And Gilgeous Alexander's got the ball here for Oklahoma City. Just a little under 2.5 minutes have passed now here in the fourth. To the paint. And there's Williams. That's good on the assist by Gilgeous Alexander. And it's 8 points for Williams.
And how about the grit and determination in the post? I mean, essential qualities to have late in a close game.
Pritchard passes to Brown. Tatum setting the pick for Brown. And Holmgren pulls it down.
And he gets a lot of points right there at the rim, but the defense determined not to give up the easy deuce there.
That's in, and the Celtic lead is cut down now to just 4 points with the basket from Williams.
And great intensity here down the stretch. He's not one to shrink in the moment.
Now take a look at him, locked in right now in this moment, wants the ball in his hands and feels real comfortable with the shot he's taking.
Timeout called, the Celtics. They're ahead by four. There's 1:54 left in the game. Holiday. He's checked in for Boston. And now we've got some time to check in from the sidelines. What do you got for us, D.A.?
Thanks, guys. During the break, listened in with Joe Mazzulla and his team. While the team is up, coach doesn't want his team to let up. He told the team to finish this game. Do not think this will be easy. We've seen comebacks before. Kevin, back to you.
Okay, David, much appreciated. Tatum looking around. And the shot is good. Tatum's got 5 points now this quarter.
Well, you know Jason Tatum can score, and that's exactly what he's done thus far.
Gilgeous Alexander against Howard. That one's in there. The Boston lead is cut down now to just four in the basket from Gilgeous Alexander. .139 left in the fourth quarter. Tatum with it. Williams picks him up. Tatum against Williams. A nice shot by Tatum. Tatum's got 11 in the second half.
And there's the frame being put to use by Tatum. He knows he's dangerous down low.
Thunder trailing by six. Holmgren with a screen on White. Pass to Gilgeous Alexander. Over Holiday. Excellent D there from Holiday. The Celtics have gone 5 of 7 from the field since the beginning of the fourth. Strong work at that end of the floor. There's Tatum. Yes, indeed, it is good. He's now 8 for 14.
I mean, he's just been brilliant today, guys, and it was the same exact story last time out.
The pass to Holmgren from the corner, and Tatum pulls it down.
He's going to be shaking his head on that one. Knows he missed an easy one.
Yeah, you can't make them all, and you for sure you'll want him taking that kind of shot.
Brown sets a screen for Tatum. Clock at four. A chance there to push it to double digits, but it's off the mark.
And I think they realize any hope of a comeback is gone.
Well, realistic at this stage of the game, they're going to lose this one, but will they take something from the loss?
And, boy, he's really in a groove. Dominant performance last game. Same thing this time out.
Seems to be nobody standing in his way. No roadblocks for him to get to his spot, capitalize, and continue to be aggressive.
And the replay demonstrating once again how aggressive that defense was.
And boy, did he get up quick to reject that shot. That's as fundamental as defense gets.
We've got 13 seconds left in the fourth quarter. And so they choose to intentionally foul. So the first one drops, and that increases their lead to 6.
And looking at Tatum's game, you know, he really doesn't have a weakness. He can give it to you in a variety of ways.
So he gets them both, and it's a 7-point game.
Some padding here on the free throw line. Some good work.
Now a timeout called by Oklahoma City. They're down by 7. We've got 13 seconds left in the fourth. We've got 13 seconds left to play in the final quarter. Frames it from downtown.
Some heads-up ball there from Dort.
And an intentional foul there stops the clock.
That's right. No other option but to foul and hope for some misses.
Gets the first, and that puts them up by 5. And so both free throws are good, and it's a 6-point ball game.
Ooh, I think that's a wrap, and I can tell you, you can't have more pressure-packed free throws than the ones that are going to seal the game.
Now a timeout called by Oklahoma City. They trail by 6. There's 10 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. Guys, what's your take?
There's still a sliver of hope.
Yeah, act fast, but without mistakes.
There's 10 seconds left in the fourth quarter. It's good from beyond the arc.
And this is the time when you want to lock it down defensively. Thus far, not happening.
I'm looking out there trying to find one guy at least interested in playing defense. Not that last possession.
First free throw is good, and that gives them a 4-point cushion. Second one is good. Getting both at the line, and it's a 5-point game. Pass to Williams from deep. Here's Dort. No good. So we see Boston get the win here. It was up for grabs right until the final seconds.
Yeah, and for me, Kevin, what stood out is just the overall trust this group has in one another when it matters most. Doing what had to be done and to send these fans home happy.
Well, folks, that's going to do it for now. For Brent Berry, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. As New Balance presents our player of the game, Jason Tatum.